students, welcome to MS class. Already in previous class I explained about transverse section of leaf. If you want to observe the leaf internally, you have to cut the leaf horizontally, and if you will observe a microscope, we can find out internal structure of leaf. Once again I repeat that topic. If you will observe in leaf, we can find out two sides, upper and lower side. Upper and lower side, upper side have more chlorophyll pigment than lower ones, that is called palisade parenchyma. Lower tissue is called spongy parenchyma. Upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Epidermis covered by a layer known as cuticle. In between of two epidermal layers, we can find out a tissue known as mesophyll tissues. In mesophyll tissues, upper side we can find out palisade parenchyma and lower side we can find out spongy parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma have more chlorophyll pigment, that's why palisade parenchyma have dark green in color. Spongy parenchyma have less chlorophyll pigments, that's why this will be light green in color. In palisade parenchyma, if you will observe, cells are tightly packed. You have to observe in your textbook. And spongy parenchyma, we can find out cells are loosely packed. In between of palisade and spongy parenchyma, we can find out a tissue known as vascular tissue, that is called xylem and phloem. Xylem transport water, we know that. Phloem transport food material. Both united together is called vascular bundle. If you will observe in lower epidermis, we can find out some openings, natural openings called stomata, which are helpful for exchange of gases and transpiration. What do you mean by transpiration? I will explain in third lesson. Transpiration means already you learnt in 9th class also. Removal of excess water present in the plant in the form of water vapor is known as transpiration. These stomata are surrounded by kidney or bean shaped cells known as guard cells, that is the structure of leaf, transverse section of leaf. Now I will explain about another important topic in first lesson, NS subject nutrition, that is called chloroplast. Already in previous class, I explained about two scientists. One is Cavento Pelletier and second one is Julius von Sachs. Cavento and Pelletier said that green parts can perform photosynthesis. He named that green parts are chlorophyll. Julius von Sachs said that green parts present in a special organelle called chloroplast. Now I will explain about chloroplast. Very very important in the exam point of view. Explain the structure of chloroplast with the help of diagram. For this you have to draw the diagram and you have to write the parts and you have to explain the diagram also. If you will observe in chloroplast, we can find out three membranes. This is first membrane, second membrane, third membrane. Membrane means a layer. What is that first membrane? Outer membrane. Means outer layer which surround the chloroplast. And second one is inner membrane. Outer membrane, inner membrane, and third membrane which we can find out in the chloroplast known as thylakoid membrane. How many membranes we can find out in the chloroplast? Three membranes: outer membrane, inner membrane, thylakoid membrane. This is the first part. What is the shape? If you will observe the shape of chloroplast, what is the shape of chloroplast? How it looks like? How it look like? Means oval shape or disc shaped structure. Where chloroplasts are present? This chloroplast present in green parts of the plant. Where green parts will be present? Leaves and younger stems. If you will observe thylakoid membrane here, we can find out stalk. This is known as grana. What is meant by grana? Stalk. Stalks of thylakoid membrane called grana. If you will observe here, we can find out a stalk like this, no? like this will be thyroid cord membrane present one upon another. No, that is called stalk. Stalk means bundle. If you will keep books one upon another, that is called stalk, bundle. The stalks of thyroid cord membrane called grana. If you will observe, this grana consists of some people, some students also, a doubt will be arise in your mind. Where chlorophyll is present? In the chloroplast. Chlorophyll is present in the grana of chloroplast. Chlorophyll. We know that chlorophyll is a pigment. Which color pigment? Green color pigment present in this part called grana. Do you know, children? Along with chlorophyll, other pigments, very important, other pigments also present in grana. What are other pigments? Here I will write. Other pigments. Chlorophyll is the major pigment, we know that. That is present in the grana. Along with chlorophyll, other pigments also present in grana. What are the other pigments? One is keratin. Write down in your textbook or notes. This is not there in your textbook. Keratin. This is the other pigment. And also xanthophyll. These two are the other pigments also present in grana along with the chlorophyll. All we know that chlorophyll is the green color pigment which helpful to trap solar energy to prepare starch. Along with chlorophyll, other pigments called keratin and xanthophyll also present in grana, which responsible for photosynthesis. And if you will observe here, we can find out colorless area called stroma. Colorless area called stroma. And we can find out some lipid globules, and a loop of DNA, starch grain. These are the parts of chloroplast. So, once again, I repeat the structure of chloroplast. Very important, 8 points, 4 marks. Chloroplast, first point. Chloroplast is a oval or disc-shaped structure present in the green parts of the plant. That is the first point. Second point, each chloroplast consists of 3 membranes. What are the 3 membranes? Outer membrane, inner membrane, thylakoid membrane. 3 membranes. This is the second point. Third point, the stalks of thylakoid membrane, the stalk means bundle of thylakoid membrane called grana. This is the third point. Fourth point, chlorophyll and other pigments known as keratin and xanthophyll present in grana. This is the fourth point. Fifth point, colorless area present in chloroplast known as stroma. This is the fifth point. And light reaction. What is meant by light reaction? I will explain the next topic. Light reaction takes place in grana and dark reaction takes place in stroma. What is meant by light reaction and what is meant by dark reaction? I will explain in the next topic. Chloroplast is the seventh point. This is there are two types of chlorophyll pigments present in grana. What are the two types? There are chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B. There are two types of chlorophyll pigments present in grana. That is chlorophyll A, blue-green in color. Chlorophyll B, yellow-green in color. This is the seventh point. Eighth point, very, very important. Chloroplast is the structure which helpful to trap solar energy to prepare starch in the process of photosynthesis. This is the eighth point, very important exam point. Again, I repeat. Chloroplast is a disc-shaped or oval-shaped structure present in the green parts of the plant. Each chloroplast consists of 3 membranes, that is outer membrane, inner membrane, thylakoid membrane. The stalks of thylakoid membrane called grana. Chlorophyll and other axillary pigments means extra pigments, keratin and xanthophyll present in grana. The colorless area present in chloroplast known as stroma. Light reaction takes place in grana and the dark reaction takes place in stroma. There are two types of chlorophyll pigments present in grana, that is chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B. Chlorophyll A is yellow green, blue green in color. Chlorophyll B is yellow green in color. Chloroplast is the structure which helps to trap solar energy to prepare starch in the process of photosynthesis. This is about chloroplast. Now I will explain about mechanism of photosynthesis. What is meant by mechanism? How photosynthesis takes place? There are two reactions. One is light reaction, second one is dark reaction. Light reaction discovered by Robert Hilly. He is a scientist who discovered light reaction. That's why this reaction also called as Hill reaction. The light reaction discovered by Robert Hill. Already we know that light reaction means the reaction which it takes place in the presence of sunlight, known as light reaction, simply called as light dependent reaction. Light dependent reaction means the reaction which it takes place in the presence of light. What are there are three major steps present in the light reaction. Step 1, step 2, step 3. So what is meant by step 1? When chlorophyll pigment traps solar energy, already explained in the previous classes. Light rays consist of small particles called photons, contains energy called quantum. When photons absorbed by chlorophyll pigment, the chlorophyll pigment will be active. After that, second step, after absorbing photons, already we know that photons consist of energy called quantum. Split means break down. Water, H2O, into H plus and OH minus. This reaction called as photolysis. Photo means light. Lysis means break. This light breaks water, H2O. This light consists of energy called quantum, breaks H2O, water, into H plus and OH minus ions. This is known as Hill reaction. Why? Because this reaction was discovered by Robert Hill. That's why this reaction also called as Hill reaction. In the third step, H plus ions, when water molecule breaks down H plus and OH minus ions, this OH minus ions helps to form water and oxygen. This oxygen escaped into the atmosphere. And remaining, what will be H plus? No. This H plus ions helpful to form ATP. ATP means energy. And NADPH. This is a electron acceptor. If you will observe the light reaction, we can find out oxygen is the end product. And ATP and NADPH are the end products. If you will observe these three steps, step 1, step 2, step 3, there are three end products. One is oxygen escaped in the atmosphere. ATP will be formed. This is energy with the help of H plus ions, and NADPH also formed. Up to here, light reaction will be completed, discovered by Robert Hill. This light reaction takes place in a grana of chloroplast. Second reaction, dark reaction. This reaction also called as light independent reaction. Why? Because this reaction does not require light. Stroma is a place there. No, here the colorless area called stroma, where dark reaction takes place. Dark reaction means the reaction which takes place in the absence of light. This was discovered by a scientist called Melvin Kelvin. He is a scientist who discovered dark reaction. This dark reaction does not require light. Discovered by Melvin Kelvin, takes place in the stroma of chloroplast. Already oxygen which released during light reaction escaped into the atmosphere. No, and two end products are there. No, what are they? ATP and NADPH. These two combined with carbon dioxide. If you will observe in the light reaction, we can find out water, and we can find out chlorophyll, and we can find out light. Three requirements we can find out in the light reaction. We cannot find out carbon dioxide in the light reaction. That's why carbohydrates are not formed in light reaction. Why? Because carbon dioxide is absent in the light reaction. We can find out only three factors in light reaction. One is water. Second one is chlorophyll. Third one is light. Only three factors available. The fourth factor is not available in light reaction. That's why carbohydrates are not formed. So in dark reaction, the end products of light reaction, ATP and NADPH, combined with the carbon dioxide to form glucose. This glucose converts into starch. So glucose or starch formed in dark reaction. So what are the end products of light reaction? ATP and NADPH are the end products of light reaction used in dark reaction with the help of carbon dioxide to form glucose or starch. So after formation of starch, photosynthesis will be completed. So this dark reaction takes place in stroma of chloroplast discovered by Melvin Kelvin. So this is about mechanism of photosynthesis. Last topic, that is events in photosynthesis. What are the three events which it takes place in chloroplast during photosynthesis? First one is light energy converts into chemical energy. Chemical energy means here food is formed, no? That is called chemical energy. With the help of sunlight, green plants prepare starch food, that is called chemical energy. Second one is splitting of water molecule. Splitting of water molecule, already explained here. With the help of quantum energy present in light rays, split water molecule into H plus and OH minus ions. Third one is CO2 is reduced into carbohydrates. So this is the third event in photosynthesis, already explained. With the help of ATP, NADPH produced in light reaction, with the help of carbon dioxide, starch is formed. That is called the third event in respiration. These are the three major events in photosynthesis. Light, first event is light energy converts into chemical energy. Chemical means food energy. Splitting of water molecule, that is called photolysis. Photo means light, lysis means breaking. Light breaks water into H plus and OH minus ions. Third one, CO2. Is reduced into carbon dioxide, carbohydrate, that is called starch. These are the three events in photosynthesis. Up to here, children, we completed autotrophic nutrition. Okay, means photosynthesis, how photosynthesis takes place by green plant. In the next class, I will explain about heterotrophic nutrition. Thank you.